إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدِ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Abu Malik al-Ash'ari, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Alhamdulillahi tamla'u al-mizan. وَسُبْحَانَ وَالْحَمْدُلِلَّهِ تَمْنَانَ وَتَمْلَأُ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. In this portion of the hadith in the Sahih of Sunnah of Tirmidhi, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Alhamdulillah fills the scales, and Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah, they fill what is between the heavens and the earth. We have been blessed with this phrase, a simple phrase, light on our tongue, beloved to Allah, virtuous and reward, the phrase of Alhamdulillah. But we need to remind ourselves about some of the areas that we need to acknowledge and praise Allah for, that we constantly fail to praise Allah for, and things that we take for granted. Alhamdulillah for Islam, for this pure deen of Tawheed. وَإِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Because the religion with Allah is al-Islam. So this is a ni'mah and a blessing that we should praise Allah for, that we were guided to this. Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he said, Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lil Islam wa manna alayna bihi wa akhrajna fi khayri ummah. Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he said, what means all praise is due to Allah who guided us to Islam, bestowed a favor upon us with it, and he raised us to be the best of nations. This is not something that you per se chose. Allah guided you to this and allowed it to happen, and brought you into this deen of pure tawheed, and to be of the best of the nations. وَقَالَ اعْلَمُوا أَنَّ الْإِسْلَامُ هُوَ السُّنَّةُ وَالسُّنَّةَ هِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ وَلَا يَقُومُ أَحَدُهُمَا إِلَّا بِالْآخِرِ. And Imam al-Barbahari, he continued saying, know that Islam is the sunnah, and the sunnah is Islam. One of them cannot be established except with the other. Alhamdulillah, that we were guided to worship Allah, the Lord and creators of the heavens and the earth, alone without partners, not to worship His Son that He doesn't even have, not to worship Him as a human God or a God that lived on this earth, not to worship Him as an idea or an essence, not to worship Him as a statue, but Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the earth and all that exists, the only one without any need for help, without any fatigue. He created everything we see and everything we don't see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلِدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَلِيٌّ مِنَ الظُّلِّ وَكَبِّرْهُ تَكْبِيرًا. Allah says what means, and say, All praise be to Allah and thanks be to Allah who has not begotten a son nor any offspring and who has no partner in his dominion, his rule, his kingdom of the heavens and the earth. Nor is he low to have a wali, a helper or a protector or a supporter and magnify him with all the magnificence by saying Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah for all of these that Allah brought us to be able to say أصبحنا وامسينا على فطرة الإسلام وكلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Alhamdulillah that we were blessed to be able to wake up or reach the evening on any given day that Allah chooses, to say that we have entered a new day upon the natural pure religion of Islam, of Tawheed, the word of sincere devotion, the religion of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the faith of our father Ibrahim alayhi salam. He was upright in worshipping Allah, and he was a Muslim, and he was not of those who used to worship others besides Allah. Say Alhamdulillah every day that you're a Muslim. Say Alhamdulillah every day that you're blessed being on this Tawheed of only worshipping one Lord alone without any partners. Alhamdulillah for the fitrah of al-Islam, the cleanliness that we were blessed with, that we were guided to do, with the tahara to be clean and live clean. And in a way, it also purifies us from our sins. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الفطرة خمس أو خمس من الفطرة الختان والاستحداد وتقليم الأظافر ونطف الإبط وقص الشارب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in an authentic hadith, five acts are part of this natural fitra of cleanliness, of purity, of wholesome living, and that clean way of living. It is circumcision, shaving the pubic hairs for the male and the female, cutting the nails of the hands and the toe for the male and the female, not going beyond 40 days, plucking the hair under the armpits for the male and the female, and clipping the mustache for the male above the lip so that it is short and it doesn't hang over the lip on top. This was a blessing that we were guided on how to be clean and live clean, to not soil ourselves with urine. We see how filthy people can be when they use the restroom. Show no regard to take care of cleanliness, but Islam blessed us with that. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من توضأ فأحسن الوضوء خرجت خطاياه من جسده حتى تخرج من تحت أظفاره. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, whoever does wudu and he does it correctly and he does it properly, his sins come out of his body, even if they come out from under his nails. So this wudu we were blessed with, brothers, please refrain from any talking. This wudu we were blessed with, that we were blessed with, it allows our sins to be washed off of our body every time we make it. Alhamdulillah for the salah, especially the sujood, which was the beauty of the eyes for the eyes, the key to Jannah, and the position to be the closest to our Lord. قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ جُعَلَتْ قُرَّةَ عَيْنِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, the salah has been made the beauty of my eyes and the coolness of my eyes. This salah is a gift. Yet many of us, وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَ. They get up, when they get up for prayer, they get up lazily, as if it's a burden. This is a blessing that we were able to have a prayer. Between each prayer, the sins are forgiven, that you could bow and prostrate to your Lord above the heavens and the earth. عن جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال أن قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مفتاح الجنة الصلاة ومفتاح الصلاة الوضوء رواه الترمذي وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the key to Jannah, to paradise, is this prayer. And the key to the prayer is the wudu. Allah gave you a key to Jannah. If I gave you a key to a mansion, you would take it. If I gave you a key to anything that you could then put in your name, you would take it. The key to Jannah was given to all of us by the day we entered Islam and by the day we had that command to follow of praying the salawat, to pray the prayers. So what will you do with that key? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد فأكثر الدعاء. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the closest a servant is to his Lord is when he's prostrating. How many people prostrate still like they're pecking, like a woodpecker pecks on the ground looking for food. This is the closest you are to your Lord, not physically. As we know, Allah said, أَنَّهُ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Allah, He created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. Then He ascended above His arsh in a manner which suits His majesty. We don't ask how. But He went above His throne separate from His creation. But when you make sajda, you are the closest, in the closest position. Even though you're at the lowest point of the earth, you're standing on that Allah hears you. He sees you. And He's ready to aid you, guide you, protect you, shelter you, console you, and give you anything that you need. That sajda, alhamdulillah, that we are blessed with the sajda. And we ask Allah to always make us of those who are the sajideen, who prostrate to Him. Alhamdulillah, say alhamdulillah. Ask Allah to keep your body fit so you can always make sujood to Him. Alhamdulillah for zakat al-mal, given to us to purify our wealth and to earn the pleasure of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, يَوْمَ يُحْمَ عَلَيْهَا فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ فَتُقْوَى بِهَا جِبَابُهُمْ وَجُنُوبُهُمْ وَظُهُورُهُمْ هَذَا مَا كَنَزْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ فَذُوقُوا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْنِزُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran, what means on the day of resurrection, when al-kanz, gold, silver, your money will be in the hell, will be made to be heated in the hellfire, because the zakat was not paid on it. And with it, the foreheads of the people will be branded, and their flanks and their backs, and it will be said to them, this is the treasure that you used to hoard for yourselves. Now taste what you used to hoard. This the effect for the one who used to have wealth and not pay the zakat on it. Khalid ibn Aslam, he said, قَالَ خَرَجْنَا مَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ بْنِ عُمَرِ فَقَالَ هَذَا قَبْلَ أَن تُنزِلَ الزَّكَاةِ فَلَمَّا أُنزِلَتْ جَعَلَهَا اللَّهُ طُهْرًا لِلْأَمْوَالِ. He said, we went out with Abdullah ibn Umar, and he said, this verse was revealed before the prescription of zakat. And when zakat was prescribed, Allah made it a means to purify your wealth. This is the way to purify the wealth. So don't get that thought of holding back on paying the zakat to purify your wealth. Pay it. Free yourself of that punishment on the day of resurrection. Alhamdulillah for the siyam. Many people, they dread it because of the love for food, or they're thinking that that's what they need more than they need Allah for their energy or whatever it takes. Alhamdulillah for the fasting that Allah blessed us to be able to do for Him in our lifetimes, which provides a reward from Allah and a protection from the hellfire. Abu Hurairah, he narrates that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, يقول الله عز وجل الصوم لي وأنا أجزي به يدعو شهوته وأكله وشربه من أجلي والصوم جنة. The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this hadith Qudsi, the fasting you do is for me. All your other deeds are for yourself. But when you fast, your fasting is for me, and I'll give the reward for it because you have left off your desires and your food and your drink for me. And this fasting, it is a screen and a protection from the hellfire. Alhamdulillah for the siyam that Allah gives us the option to be able to do, or the command to do in the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah for the hajj, a journey you're asked to do once in your lifetime. But if you do it, you can come back like the day born to your mom with no sins. From Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he mentions that the Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ حَجَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ فَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ رَجَعَ كَيَوْمَ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ رَوَاهُ ابْنِ مَاجَ وَهَذَا حَدِيثٌ صَحِيحٌ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, whoever performs hajj to this house of Mecca, Masjid al-Haram, the Masjid al-Haram in Mecca and Saudi Arabia, and does not have intimate relations with their spouse, nor do they commit sins or disobedience or anger or lewdness, they will go back like the day they were born to their mother. One journey, a few days, we will toil hard just to make a dollar. This is one journey in your lifetime, and you will come back like you had no sin that you ever committed in your life. Alhamdulillah for the opportunities Allah gives us to wipe ourselves of sin. Alhamdulillah for this Quran, the speech of Allah, Kalam Allah, the words of Allah. And we say this not bending or distorting the reality, not saying how Allah talks. We're not talking about that. Those are knowledge, that's knowledge for Allah to know. But we affirm Kalam Allah, the speech of Allah, the words of Allah, because Allah affirmed them in His book, and His Messenger ﷺ affirmed them in the Sunnah. So we affirm all of those things. This was the final message, the lifeline for salvation to all of mankind. The words of Allah. Consider it a book, a letter, whatever you want to consider it. It's the speech of Allah as the final way for you to save yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, لَقَدَ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says what means, indeed in their stories there's a lesson for men of understanding. This Quran is not forged, it was not made up, it was not written by a human. It is the words and the speech of your Lord. It is a confirmation of Allah's existing books from before, the Tawrat and the Injil and the other scriptures of Allah, and a detailed explanation for everything, and a guide and a mercy for the people who believe. That's what this book is. The one that we desert every month out of the year except for Ramadan. This book is the speech of Allah, the words of Allah, the message to all of humanity. In it is an explanation for everything in the way you can save yourself. It was narrated from Anas ibn Malik that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْلِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. To Allah, He has a special group of people, His own people, His own special ones. The companions, they said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ مَنْ هُمْ. They said, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are Allah's special people? Who is His own people, His group? He said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, هم أهل القرآن أهل الله وخاصته. They are the people of the Quran. They are the people of Allah and His special ones and the ones closest to Him. Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahu Allah, may Allah preserve our Shaykh for us. He stated, if the person has implemented the Quran, انتبهوا, listen, if the person has implemented the Quran, but he has not memorized it, he is considered to be from Ahl al-Quran, from the people of the Quran. If you implement the book of Allah, if you learn its tafsir, if you try to put it into action, even if you have not memorized it, you can still be of this special group to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah for our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of mankind, the best one to take as a role model and an example, the one who lived in his life, coming to say, أَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ, to say, worship Allah, your Lord and my Lord, that Allah is one. And because of it, he suffered torment and abuse, physical and verbal. He was ridiculed and mocked, beaten on many occasions. But he stuck to that because he knew it was the truth. We have in him the best example. Say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon him 10 times in the morning and the evening, you will earn his shafa'ah. If you say, Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad, 10 times in the morning and the evening, his shafa'ah, his intercession, he will beg Allah to forgive you for your major sins on the day of resurrection. Such a simple task. لَقَدَ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهُ الْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah says what means indeed in the Messenger of Allah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have the best example to follow for him who hopes in the meeting with Allah on the last day and he remembers Allah much. Alhamdulillah for our parents who were given to us as a blessing to raise us up from when we are little, to teach us the ways of life, to guide us, to bring to us and to teach us Islam, to help us stay on a path which is pleasing to Allah. And this is what true love is. It's not this material junk we see nowadays where love has become mere materialistic, and that's what the kids expect. True love is you bring them up worshipping Allah, knowing their Creator. So honor your parents, never abandon them, do not disrespect them in any way, because you can achieve Allah's pleasure and enter Jannah through the best of its gates, of the 8 gates of Jannah, the gates of Bir al-Walidain, those who were good to their parents. And Abu Abdurrahman al-Sulami, he narrated from Abu Darda that he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, Al-Walidu awsat abwab al-Jannah, that the parent is the best and the middle door of the doors and the gates of Jannah. فَإِنْ شِئْتْ فَأَضِعْ ذَلِكَ الْبَابْ أَوْ أَحْفَظُهُ. So you either want to lose that door by not being good to them, or you want to preserve it and take care of it so you enter Jannah from the gates of the one who was good to their parents. عن معاوية ابن جاهمة السلمي أن جاهمة جاء إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ف فقال يا رسول الله أردت أن أغزو وقد جئت أستشيرك فقال هل لك من أم هل لك من أم قال نعم قال فألزمها فإن الجنة تحت رجليها. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this hadith, which is sahih in the Sunnah bin Nisa'i, and there are many versions of it that people quote that are da'if, they're not accepted, the hadith is weak. But this one is authentic. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, O Messenger of Allah, I want to go out and fight in the cause of Allah, and I've come to ask your advice. He said, do you have a mother? Is your mother alive? He said, yes. He said, then stick with her, stay with her, be a companion to her, nurture her, be kind to her, take care of her, because Jannah is beneath her feet, because Jannah lies at her feet. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, he said, رِضَ الرَّبْ مِنْ رِضَ الْوَالِدِ وَسَخَطُ الرَّبْ مِنْ سَخَطِ الْوَالِدِ, that the anger of Allah is tied to the anger of your parents with you. The pleasure of Allah is tied to the pleasure of your parents with you. And the anger or the wrath of Allah will be tied to if your parents are angry with you. So be mindful of this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Alhamdulillah, be patient with this one. For every sickness and illness and hardship. You may say, who would say Alhamdulillah for that? A Muslim would. And the Muslim is the one who's been blessed to say Alhamdulillah on every occasion. So we say Alhamdulillah for every sickness and illness and hardship through which our sins can be removed and we are purified, some to the point that they'll meet Allah with no sin, so you can go to Jannah. So don't be of those who put F word cancer, or those who curse the fever or curse illnesses. This is not the way of the Muslim. And it's become the way of society to say F word this disease, F word that disease, F word COVID and everything else in its way. We do not speak like that as Muslims. We do not curse what Allah sent. We are patient with it and know that as a trial, it's only to our benefit. And Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, wa Abu Hurayrata radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, ما يصيب المسلم من نصب ولا وصب ولا هم ولا حزن ولا أذى ولا غم حتى الشوكة يشاقها إلا كفر الله بها من خطاياه. رواه البخاري. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, no fatigue, no disease, no sorrow, no heart, no sadness, no hurt, no distress, no hardship befalls a Muslim, even if it was a prick of a thorn that they got from cutting a rose or picking a lemon or an orange or whatever it may be, but Allah will expiate some sins for that. Allah will take away sins, any hardship, any distress, any sadness, any sorrow. Allah will wipe away sins for you being patient with it. وَقَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَنْ يُرِدُ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرٌ يُصِبْ مِنْهُ. When Allah wants to do good for a person, when Allah loves a person, يُصِبْ مِنْهُ, He gives them trials and hardships, afflictions to go through, so that he can get sins wiped out and be close to his Lord on the day of resurrection and in Jannah بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. وَعَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما يزال البلاء لا يزال البلاء بالمؤمن والمؤمنة في نفسه وولده وماله حتى يلقى الله تعالى وما عليه خطيئة. This hadith, which is Hassan Sahih in the Sunnah of Tirmidhi, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, a Muslim, male or female, continues to remain under trial in their life with respect to their life, with respect to their property, with respect to their offspring, their children, until he faces Allah with no sin recorded on him. This is the one who bears with patience the tests and the trials, the hardships and the sadness, the depression, the anxiety they fear in this life or they go through in this life. Allah will wipe away your sins so you meet him as if you never sinned. What more better thing than that? أَقُولُ قَلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ أَدُعُ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وبعد, الحمد لله, الحمد لله تملأ الميزان, الحمد لله رب العالمين, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Alhamdulillah, praise Allah every day. Such a beautiful phrase we've been blessed with, so light on the tongue. The reward with Allah is immense. Alhamdulillah for the blessings we've been given. More than we could ever enumerate, more than we can acknowledge. Alhamdulillah for every ni'mah, every blessing, every mercy to try and help us reach Jannah. We praise Allah for that. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أرى ما يحب قال الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات وإذ قال وإذ رأى ما يكره قال الحمد لله على كل حال. Aisha, she reported رضي الله عنها, may Allah be pleased with her, with the mother of the believers. She said, if the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw something he liked or heard some good news he liked, he said, Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah by whose favor good deeds are accomplished. And if there was something that happened that he didn't like or was negative or seemed to be bad, he said, Alhamdulillah is due to Allah in every circumstance. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Alhamdulillah, when we wake up, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعدما ماتنا وإليه النشور. Allah wakes us up from the state of death, of sleep. And to Him is our resurrection. Praise Allah, it's another day for you to serve Him, to worship Him, to ask Him for forgiveness and to seek His mercy. Alhamdulillah, when we're done eating and drinking. Alhamdulillah, من الذي أطعمنا. Allah عز وجل. Alhamdulillah, الذي أطعمنا وسقانا وجعلنا من المسلمين. Praise be to Allah who has given us our food, our drink, and made us from those who are Muslim. Alhamdulillah for the mercy and the forgiveness and the opportunity to do tawbah when we sin, not just if you sin once, you're out. It's not like one of those competitions where you lose twice and you're out of it forever. No, Allah always opens the door for tawbah. قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ التَّاؤُبُ مِنَ الذَّنْبِ كَمَنْ لَا ذَنْبَ لَهُ. That the one who repents from a sin, it's as if he or she did not sin. Look at the mercy. Alhamdulillah that we have a merciful Lord. Alhamdulillah that we have a Lord who accepts our seeking of forgiveness and accepts our repentance and forgives us for our sins. عن أبي أمامة عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن صاحب الشمال ليرفع القلم ست ساعات عن العبد المسلم المخطئ أو المسيء فإن ندم واستغفر الله منها ألقاها وإلا كتب واحدة. This hadith, which was graded Hassan by Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, verily the angel of the left side, the angel over our left shoulder who records all our sins and bad deeds, he raises his pen when you sin or make an error for 6 hours at the command of Allah. And he, if he sincerely regrets it and he seeks forgiveness for his sin, then that angel will throw that sin aside and not write it. Otherwise, he will record it as one sin. This is Allah al-Halim. Look at His mercy, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, He gives us the chance that when we fail and fail and fail and fail, because this world ain't forgiving, but we have a Lord who is. So always run to Him in repentance. Alhamdulillah, for all the easy things we were given. Saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim, la ilaha illallah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, min kunuz al-jannah, from the treasures of Jannah. All of these phrases that we can say to just load our scale of good deeds on the Day of Judgment. So it shouldn't even be one of those close calls. Alhamdulillah for all those ni'am, those blessings. Alhamdulillah for the blessing of Allah, for the servant who leaves something haram for his sake. And so he is rewarded with better. عن أبي كتادة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنك لم تضع شيئا لله عز وجل إلا بدلك الله به ما هو خير لك منه. This hadith, which is in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad and Sheikh al-Albani, he authenticated it. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, verily, you will never leave anything for the sake of Allah, but that Allah will replace it with something better. So don't think twice leaving the haram you may be doing, especially in tijara and business. If you're involved with riba, if you're involved with alcohol, if you're involved with drugs, if you're involved with gambling, if you're involved with any of these things, leave it. Allah will replace it with something better. Allah will give you something better, more wholesome, more pure, and better for you to live upon. This is a promise from Allah that you will have that replacement. So don't think twice about the worries Shaitan tries to plant in your head. Alhamdulillah, for all of the bodily gifts and blessings we have been given that we take advantage of, and we don't see as anything, as a gift or as a blessing. Many of these things, take into mind your heart. Your heart for the average person, let's say, we're just talking about the average person, not an athlete, and not someone who's really sick. The heart beats, let's just say, 70 beats a minute. In one day, your heart beats over 100,000 times. Do you say Alhamdulillah for every heartbeat? Because there are some who don't have a heart that's beating well. It needs a machine, or it's struggling to get air. Let's say you say the 100,000 Alhamdulillah a day. You're still forgetting other things have to happen for that heart to beat. The lungs, it's a muscle. The air goes in that you breathe in every breath. The average person, 12 to 16 breaths a minute. Call it 15 for the math. If you breathe 15 times a minute in your day, that's 21,000 breaths just to get oxygen into the blood to let the rest of your body survive. This isn't a science lesson. But look at this and reflect. Your brain, your liver, your kidneys, your gallbladder, your stomach, your pancreas, your intestines, your muscles, your blood, your eyes, your ears, your nose, your senses, your limbs, your hands, your feet. All of these take so much for them to function. And we don't even come close to praising Allah for them. Alhamdulillah for all of these things. Allah is the creator. Ain't no big bang ever happened to create something so perfect. This takes the work of Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, that created all of this imperfection. And we are so short in affirming this power of Allah and praising Him for it all. Alhamdulillah, He tamla'u al-mizan. Alhamdulillah will fill the scales, my brothers and sisters in Islam. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَ لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِيَ لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَ اللَّهِ. This is the statement of the people of paradise, may Allah make us from them, that they will say, all praise and thanks be to Allah who guided us to this. Never could we have found this guidance were it not that Allah had guided us to this. Indeed, the messengers of our Lord did come with the truth. And it will be cried out to them, وَنُودُوا أَن تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةُ أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. This is the paradise which you've inherited for what you used to do. So be of them. هُوَ الْحَيُّ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَادْعُوهُ مُخْلَصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah, He is the ever-living. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. None has the right to be worshipped but Him. So invoke Him and make your worship purely for Him. By worshipping Him alone and none else. By doing the righteous deeds for Allah's sake, not for showing off. And do not set up rivals with Allah and worship. All praise and thanks be to Allah, Lord of the Alameen. Finishing up, عن عمران بن حسين, he said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن أفضل عباد الله يوم القيامة الحمادون. إن أفضل عباد الله يوم القيامة الحمادون. This hadith, which is sahih, according to Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, he said, verily the best servants on the day of resurrection, the best of all of the ibad, all the slaves of Allah, are those who were constantly praising Allah, constantly saying Alhamdulillah, constantly praising Allah at every turn they could get, good times or bad, young, old, free time or busy, they always found ways to praise Allah. So remember that with the hadith of Abdullah ibn Musa, radiallahu anhu, where he reported that one of the companions said, O Messenger of Allah, there's many injunctions in Islam. Give me something that I can benefit from. He said, لَا يَزَالُ لِسَانُكَ رَطْبًا مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Always keep your tongue wet with the remembrance of Allah, and from those remembrances, from the best of them, to be of the most successful ibad on the Day of Judgment, may Allah make us from them, is the hammadun, the ones who say Alhamdulillah. So keep your tongue wet with this. We have been blessed with this phrase that fills the scales, that is light on the tongue, that is mentioned in the Fatiha to remind us of always praising Allah, that our Prophet ﷺ used to say on all occasions and situations. So let us praise Allah the way He deserves to be praised. Allahumma laka alhamd, anta rabbu samawati wal ardi wa man fihinna falaka alhamd, anta qayyum samawati wal ardi wa man fihinna falaka alhamd, anta nur samawati والأرض ومن فيهن فلك الحمد. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.